morning. What's going on?
Oh, hey, Miranda. I've been trying to make this gingerbread house, but every time I try to put the roof on, the walls start bending and they break.
It sounds like maybe your gingerbread cookies don't have the right materials properties to be used to build a house. What recipe are you using?
Well, you see, I'm using this recipe called the most delicious gingerbread cookies ever.
Well, that could be the problem. Let's take a look at the material science tetrahedron. The tetrahedron shows the relationship between the four pillars of material science: structure, processing, properties, and performance. Performance refers to how well suited a material is for its intended function. The intended performance for the most delicious gingerbread cookies ever is to be enjoyable to eat. So the targeted properties will be things like being well spiced, soft, and fluffy. By contrast, the intended performance of gingerbread cookies for building houses is to perform well as the walls and roof of a house, not to taste the best. Instead of being soft and fluffy, we want it to be structurally sound so that it can support the house's weight.
That makes sense. But how can we modify the recipe to make more structurally sound cookies? When I was comparing recipes online, I found some that used a lot of butter and some that didn't use much butter at all. Maybe that's a factor?
That's a really good idea. Butter contains water, which can become steam at the high temperatures used for baking, creating air pockets in cookies. I think we have our hypothesis. We predict that decreasing the amount of butter in the gingerbread cookie recipe will make cookies which are denser and thus more structurally sound. This hypothesis is an example of how changing the structure can influence the properties and performance of a material. Decreasing the butter content reduces the steam and air pockets produced, which makes for a denser, more structurally sound cookie, which gives us a better building material.
That makes sense. Let's test this out by actually making some cookies. How about we make one batch with my original recipe, and we can make a second batch with less butter and see how that affects things.
Sounds great. And to be fair, we won't change anything else about the recipe to limit the number of variables.
Okay, let's get started.
Let's go.
Alright, so now that we have our cookies, how can we test them and compare their properties?
That's a good question. The process of testing a material's properties is called characterization. I think there's some mechanical characterization equipment in the lab at MIT we could use. I'll go check. Hey, Seamus.
Hi.
I've been working on improving my gingerbread cookie recipe. Would you mind helping me test it?
Yeah, of course.
What materials properties are most important for materials that we're using to build, say, a gingerbread house?
Well, the most important properties for making a gingerbread house would probably be strength. It needs to be able to withstand all the forces and all the loads to keep the house upright and straight. But it also needs to be have some ductility. We want the gingerbread to be slightly ductile rather than brittle. A brittle material just snaps and it doesn't bend a little at all. It's like a dinner plate when you throw it on the floor, it just shatters. You use a mechanical testing apparatus, like this one. So we put our gingerbread onto these two bottom supports here. We then lower this top support and bend the material downward. From the data, we can figure out the bending stress and the bending strain. Stress is force divided by cross-sectional area of a material. That way we can compare materials that are really big and really small equally. And strain is where we take the change in length and divide it by the original length. This machine measures the force, and we know the position of this crosshead up and down, so we know how far to go. That's how we can calculate stress and strain.
I think we're ready to test some gingerbread now.
Sure, let's do it. So first we need to know the dimensions of our specimen. Okay, so we'll put it in. So now we're ready to go. 1, 2, 3, go. On the stress-strain curve here, we see that there's a roughly linear portion here. We call this the elastic region. It bends, but if we let it go, it goes back to its original shape. But at some point, it begins to be a little bit more curvy, not linear. We call that a plastic region. If we bent it to this point, it won't go back to its original shape. It has a maximum right around here, and then it begins to go down. That's when it begins to break, and we saw that crack forming in the cookie. And it goes down as the crack gets bigger and bigger and bigger until it reaches zero.
Let's look at a cookie made with our second recipe now.
Yeah, that'd be a good idea. I can already tell this looks different. Other than color, you can see that in the original cookie, it's less dense. There are lots of tiny little air pockets and bubbles that you don't really see in this cookie here. Fewer bubbles mean fewer areas for cracks to begin to grow. On the stress-strain curve, ductility is measured from the x-axis. That's where we measure strain. So if we look at the original cookie right here, we see that they broke around 4 to 4.5%. Compared to where there was less butter, they broke around 1.5% to 2.5%. So the low butter cookies are less ductile. As for strength, it's measured on the y-axis, where we see stress in megapascals. So if we look at the original cookie curves here, they have a failure strength around 0.1 megapascals. For the low butter cookies, they failed somewhere between 0.4 and 0.6 megapascals. So with lower butter, you have higher strength, but lower ductility.
So now that we've characterized the cookies, let's return to our original prediction. The low butter recipe produced denser cookies with fewer air bubbles, and we learned from Seamus that these cookies were stronger because they could withstand more stress before breaking. However, they're not as ductile as the original tastier recipe. Since our original problem was that our cookies weren't strong enough, let's stick with this lower butter recipe.
Sounds great. Let's get our friends together and try and make a gingerbread house with the new recipe.